Hi everyone, this is Anurag. Today in this tutorial we are going to discuss about joints. So what is a join? Let us see. For example, here there are two tables, employee table and department table. Employee table is having E number, E name, D number, and department table is having D number, D name, location. So this table is having some data. This table is having some data. Okay. I want to get details about a particular employee, where that employee is working, in which location that employee is working. So can I get the location details from this table? No. Can I get the employee name details from here? No. Here we can find location, but we cannot find the name of the employee. So some part of my required information is present in employee table, whereas some part of my required information is present in department table. So we can get our we can retrieve our required information by combining these two tables. We can combine these two tables by using join. So we use joins to combine two or more tables in order to retrieve the data. Okay. So let us see the types of joins now. Okay. So these are the three types of joins: inner joins, outer joins, and self joins. Okay. Inner joins are of two types: equi join and non equi join. Outer joins are of two types: left outer join, right outer join. And there is one more type of joins called as self joins. Now we will see equi joins. Okay. So if you see here, there are two tables. Let us see equi joins first. Here two tables are there: employee table, the example which we have seen previously. Okay. E number, E name, D number. Here D number, D name, location. Okay. Employee table is having details about three employees. Okay, departments are respectively 10, 20, 30. Here also 10, 20, 30. HR, finance, accounts. Location Hyderabad, Mumbai, and Pune. See, here two tables are there: employee table and department table. So here I want to know where this person Virat is working. Okay. I cannot get from EMP table, I cannot get the entire data from DEPT table. So I need to combine these two tables. How can I combine these both tables? Based on the D number column. There exists a direct relationship between two tables, and that is same column number, same column, and also same number of values. Okay. So what can I do here? I can perform a equi join. Okay. How to perform a equi join? Let us see. Select, that means to retrieve the data, E number, E name, EMP dot D number, comma, D name, comma, location from employee, comma, department table, where employee tables D number values equals to DEPT tables D number values. Okay. If you see here, I am taking E number, E name values from EMP table and D name location from department table. But D number column is present in both tables. Hence, I am giving here EMP dot D number from employee comma department. Here we are giving the condition, equi join condition, that is employee tables D number is equals to department tables D number values. Okay. So as a result, we can get entire this table will be combined. But I don't want that one. Entire data will be retrieved. But I want where the person employee called Virat is working. So I will give and condition, because we cannot give two where conditions in same statement. So I am giving and condition, and E name like Virat. Okay. Like this we can perform a equi join condition. Now let us see non equi join condition. Okay. So there are two tables here also, in non equi join Here two tables, EMP table and sal grade table. Okay, in this E number call, E number, E name, salary, grade, low salary and high salary. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Some example A, B, C, 5,000. So here there are two tables, employee table and salary table. If you see, there is no column same in both tables. So can we perform equijoin condition? No, but I want to see a particular employee called C in which grade this person will fall. Okay, for that I need to combine these both tables. To combine these both tables, there is no same column, but there exists an indirect relationship. At this time we can combine these two tables by using non-equijoin. So let us see how to join. Select E number comma E name comma salary comma grade from employee comma sal grade, where EMP dot salary is greater than or equals to sal grade dot low sal and EMP dot salary is less than or equals to sal grade dot high sal. If you see here, we are giving two conditions. What we give here, E number, E name, salary, grade, this will come as output. From we are taking these values from employee and salary tables, where employee dot salary, for example, take this 5000. Is 5000 greater than or equals to low sal? We will check here. Is 5000 greater than 10,000? No, this condition failed. Is 5000 greater than 5001? No, this condition failed. Now this 5000 is checked with this one. Okay, is 5000 greater than 0? Yes, that means first condition is satisfied. Then we will check here, that salary should be less than or equals to sal grade dot high sal. That means if it is equals to 5000 is equals to 5000, that means employee number A falls under third grade. Similarly, employee number 2 falls in second grade, employee number 3 falls in first grade. Okay, this is how we join two tables, though indirect relationship exists, but no same column is present in both tables. Understood the concept, right? Now let us see about outer joins. In that, let us see left outer join. First one, I am taking the same example, employee and department. Here E number, E name, D number, 1, 2, 3. And Srinath, Sachin, Virat, 3 employees are there. Departments 10, 20, 30. And here also D number, D name, location 10, 20, 30. Department is HR, Finance, Accounts. Location is some Pune, Mumbai, okay, Delhi. When this tables are there, two tables are there, there exists a direct relationship, that is D number column is same, but here some extra condition is there, 40 sales, and this is some Chennai. Okay, if you see, we can combine this both tables by using equijoin condition, but it will show only details about employee number, department number 10, 20, 30. It won't show details about department number 40. So what we should do, we should combine the both tables and we should get the extra information present in department table also. So how can we retrieve this? Select E number comma E name comma DEPT dot D number comma D name comma location from employee table comma department table, where condition is employee dot D number equals to DEPT dot D number. This is a equijoint condition. It will give details about 20, 30 departments only. It won't show details about 40th department. So we use here left outer join. See which table is having extra information? Department table. Which table is having less information? Employee table. Why? Because here in employee table 40th department is not present. Okay, so extra information is present in department table, less information is present in employee table. So give a plus symbol on the table side which is having less information. Okay, this is called left outer join. Why? Because it is on LHS, left hand side. Okay, so as a result, in output we will get employee number, employee name, department member, department name, location. We will get 40th row also. Okay, we will see this in our demo session. Okay, we are taking here D number values from department table. If I take D number values from employee table, it will show only 10, 20, 30, it won't show 40. I am taking D number values from for department table, so it will show the 40th department values also. Okay, this is about left outer join. Now let us see about right outer join. Now let us see right outer join. Here same example I am taking, employee department table. Here same E number, E name, location, sorry, D number, and some Srinath, Sachin, Virat, and 10, 20, 30, D number, D name, location, 10, 20, 30, some HR, finance, accounts. Okay, Hyderabad, Pune, Chennai. Okay, if you see here, 4, some Dravid, 40. Here extra information is now present in employee table, less information is present in department table. Now I want to, if I perform a equijoin, I will get only 10, 20, 30 details. I don't get 40th details. So what I will do, I will combine these both tables by using right outer join. See this, select E number comma E name comma EMP dot D number comma D name location from EMP comma DEPT, where condition we are giving is EMP dot D number equals to DEPT dot D number. This gives the equijoint condition, but I want to see the extra information present in employee table also. So we should give plus symbol on the table side which is having less information. Here department table is having less information, so give plus here. Okay, this will show details about 1, 10, 20, 38, 40 department also. Okay, that means we have given plus symbol on the right side, RHS side. That means we have combined the two tables by using right outer join. Okay, let us see the last type of join, that is self join. If you see here in self join, there is a employee table. It is showing details about the 5 employees. Here manager id is nothing but employee number. That means here 1 means Srinath. Srinath is the manager of Kapil. 2 means Kapil is manager of Saurav. 3 means Saurav is manager of Robin, and again Srinath is manager of Sunil. Okay, so it is almost confusing for us to check the numbers and tell. Even though it is five rows we can tell, but if the column is having 10,000 rows and each is showing the details like this, we cannot tell who, which person is manager of which person. Okay, at this time we should combine the table with itself. Why? Here we should get a table column called as manager, and it shows the manager name. For example, Kapil. If it shows like this, Srinath, Kapil, we can easily tell that Kapil is manager of Saurav. Okay, so here we need to combine the table with itself. This process is called as self join. Here this employee table is logically treated as two tables, that is employee A and employee B. Now employee A is this table and employee B is also this table. We will combine this table with this table. Employee A with employee B. That means combining the table with itself. This is called self join. How we can perform the query by using self joins? Let us see. So here we have logically divided employee table into employee A and employee B. Here the table is not divided. Table is just copied. Okay. If you see, these are virtual copies of the same table. Same information is present here. So if I want to perform a self join, I will combine this table with this table. So how can we retrieve the data? Select A dot E number. Why? Because we are taking A dot E number means we are taking E number values from A table. This table E number values are present in B table also. Okay. Then A dot E name. A dot manager ID, comma B dot E name. See, we are taking employee number, employee name, and manager ID, and also with that, I want to see the manager name also. So here column is E name. I will want to change this as manager. Okay, manager from employee A, comma employee B. Where I am giving the condition A dot MGR ID equals to B dot E number. Here I am equating ID, manager ID, with employee number. That means manager ID with employee number. I will combine like this. Okay. That means manager for Robin is Saurav. Okay. I can manage like this. Here output will be like this. Let us see that output. Output will be E number, E name, MGR ID, and manager. Okay, and it will show the values. Okay, it will show the values. Okay, like this we can perform self join. Okay, the main purpose of joins is to combine two or more tables in order to retrieve the data. Okay, so this completes about joins theory part. Now we will see the demo session in the next class. Okay, our class is completed.